Everyone, our topic is numbers and operations in 7th grade and group members are Fatma Seher Yeni, Sanem Duran, Sümeyye Ersoy and me, Ayşegül Yoldaş. Start with learning theories. We analyze our topic according to Piaget and Vygotsky's theories. According to Piaget, humans learn new information by adding the new information with meanings from previous experiences. This theory is based on two biological tendencies, organization and adaptation. There are two processes of adaptation, assimilation and accommodation. Assimilation happens when humans add the new information into schemas which they already know. If they do not fit the new knowledge into current schema, then they accommodate the new knowledge. And Vygotsky's theory has three processes. First, a learner is guided by someone. Second, the learner observes and practices their skills by social interaction. Third, teachers help guide the learner through the zone of proximal development. According to Vygotsky, the zone of proximal development is the distance between the actual development level as determined by independent problem solving and the level of potential development as determined through problem solving under adult guidance or in collaboration with more capable peers. Let's move on general aims. Current teaching program is not based on given knowledge directly by teachers. Students are expected to product, think in a high cognitive way, solve problems by devising strategies, using them in daily life and communicate. Perspective consists of values and abilities. Values are based on some of power of struggle with problems in real life and emotions such as honesty, patience and helpfulness. These values help students to gain problem-solving skills in a collaborative way. Abilities are communication in native and foreign language, mathematical, technological, digital, social abilities, learning to learn, cultural awareness and expression. Mathematical abilities let students to develop their problem-solving skills. Numbers and operations in 7th grade include 5 topics which are operations with integers, rational numbers, operations with rational numbers, ratio and proportion, and percents. Firstly, in the current curriculum, operation with integers is the continuation of the integers which are in the 6th grade. In the 8th grade, there is nothing about integers. Operation with integers has 5 objectives. Generally, it has both conceptual and procedural understanding. The objectives which includes the verbs like incelemek, ifade etmek, ilişkilendirmek are more conceptual while the objectives which need an implementation and processes are more procedural. For example, second objective is more procedural because students learn strategies rather than understand concept. Although the objectives of 2018 and 2013 look like similar, there is a difference between them. It is that addition and subtraction are taught in the 6th grade. In the 2009 curriculum, the objectives focus on making calculations rather than understanding the concept. Besides, students play a passive role. In the table, you can see the distribution of these subjects according to the years of curriculum. Rational numbers has 5 objectives in the current curriculum and it is a new term for 7th grade. Students can assimilate rational numbers to fractions, decimals and integers which they learn in 6th grade. There is no objective about rational numbers directly in 8th grade, but students can see them in a lot of contents such as real numbers and similarity between triangles. While estimation strategies of comparison are based on conceptual understanding, converting decimals and rational numbers develops algorithm and fluency. Moreover, number line and symbols of rational numbers are useful semiotics which make easier understanding according to the socio-cultural theory. Converting repeating decimals to rational numbers is not aimed in 2009 and 2013 curriculums. Moreover, while 2009 curriculum includes converting rational numbers to the decimals, which is stated as one of the ways of comparison, other two curriculums do not. As a result, we decided that while 2009 curriculum is more helpful to develop reflective thought, 2013 and 2018 curriculums are more systematical. Operations with rational numbers includes four objectives in current curriculum. There is no explanation about models, estimation, so we decide students should do operations by recognizing properties without using estimation and models. Therefore, the primary aim of these objectives are improvement of standard algorithm and procedural understanding. Moreover, students can assimilate the operations with rational numbers to previous knowledge, which are operations with fractions. Finally, the effect of minus 1 and plus 1 on multiplication is removed in 2018 curriculum because it is taught in integers. Therefore, current curriculum is away from repetition. Ratio and proportion is continuation of the ratio. Ratio is taught in the 6th grade. In the 8th grade, there is nothing about this. To understand ratio and proportion, students should learn integers and rational numbers completely. It is beneficial for students to be taught ratio before proportion. Although the ratio seems a fraction, it is a different expression. While noticing this distinction, proportion should not be included just after ratio. Otherwise, students may confuse. Moreover, the sequence of the objectives in this topic is specific to general. Thanks to this, students understand the next objective easier. Generally, this topic is conceptual in the current curriculum. Students are expected to understand on their own. 2009 curriculum focuses on giving information not making sense of topic. 2013 and 2018 curriculums are similar and they provide students to associate topics with real life. The difference between two curriculums is given some direction like using tables. Percentages includes four objectives in current curriculum. Both conceptual and procedural understanding are seen in the objectives. Objectives in the current curriculum do not give lots of details about how these objectives are carried out. If the activities and estimation part direct students to think proportionally, connect percentages to fraction decimal concepts, and support it with models, then these objectives are based on conceptual understanding. On the other hand, if they depend on using formulas and providing operations without thinking deeply to develop fluency, then it is based on procedural understanding. Connection with cognitive theory is students can assimilate the percentages to fractions and decimals. Finally, according to 2009, the topic of percentage is very undetailed and it is not good curriculum for percentage. This curriculum focuses on consumption and trade, therefore it limits the files of percentages. While connection to real life is stronger in this curriculum than 2013 and 2018 curriculums, these curriculums are more gradual than 2009 curriculum. Thanks for your attention.